One thing that can be overlooked easily is making a backup of your site. It's one of those things you don't know you need until it's too late. There are several free plugins available in WordPress for backups. The one we'll install for the course is UpdraftPlus Backup Restore. UpdraftPlus can be installed from the Add New Plugin screen. Enter UpdraftPlus, all one word, in the search box and click the search button. Locate the UpdraftPlus plugin and click the install link, the OK button, and then activate. UpdraftPlus is installed on the Settings Admin panel. This plugin schedules automatic backups of all files except the WordPress core files. It allows backups to several different platforms, including Amazon S3, and it offers a restore feature from the dashboard, all important features for a backup system. The first thing you want to do with any backup system is designate where you want the backup stored. It should be someplace other than your web server. Locate the Copying Your Backup to Remote section and select a remote storage. This will activate a screen for additional information depending on the storage selected. For the course, we'll select Amazon S3. We've already seen how to find the S3 access key and the secret key in a previous video. You should have a rootkey.csv file saved in a secure place that contains the key ID and secret key. You can use this to get the access information. We do need a bucket for the location. If you don't already have one, then create a bucket as described in a previous video. Enter the information and click the Test S3 Settings. If all is well, you'll see a success pop-up. Now click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen to save any changes. Now select which files you want to include in the backup. All the files is recommended. And choose the file backup intervals and how many to retain. I recommend 3. And the database intervals and how many, again, I recommend 3. Now click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen to save any changes. If this is the initial install of the backup system, then click the Backup Now button. This button is also handy if you make any major changes to the site and you want to have an immediate fresh backup. Simply click this button for an instant backup. And if you do need to restore from a backup, then click the Restore button. Select a backup file to restore and follow the directions. As with any backup system, there can be issues. If you have any doubts about handling this important feature, then consider using a service like BackupBuddy or VaultPress to take care of the backups for you.